Very good morning to all dear students. How are you? I hope all of you are fit and fine and doing your study properly at your home. Dear children, in previous lecture, we have discussed the definition of the matrix, what is the order of the matrix, what is row, what is column, some special type of the matrices, row matrix, column matrix, identity matrix, null matrix and many more. What is the equality of the matrix and what is the diagonal of the square matrix and diagonal matrix. Now in this lecture we will discuss some problems based on these concepts from exercise 3.1. So let us come to the exercise 3.1. In exercise 3.1, we have question number 1 in the matrix A is given 2, 5, 19, minus 7, 35, minus 2, 5 upon 2, 12, root 3, 1, minus 5, 17. And we have to give the answer of some question. First of all, we have to tell the order of the matrix. In order to find the order of the matrix, we have to know the number of rows into number of columns. So let us count the number of rows, right? See, this is first row, 2, 5, 19, minus 7. This is second row and this is third row, right? Means we have 3 rows. So number of rows will be 3. Okay, now let us count the number of columns. First column C1, C2, C3 and C4. So we have 4 columns. Means we have 3 rows and 4 columns. So order of the matrix will be 3 cross 4. Now we have to tell the number of elements. In order to find the number of elements, just multiply the number of rows by the number of columns. So 3 into 4, it is equal to 12. So there are 12 elements in this matrix. See, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12, right? Now, what is the next? Write the elements A13. We have to tell the elements A13, means we have to tell that element for which row number is 1, row number is 1 and column number is 3, right? So row number 1 is this. And column number 3 means this, right? So the element is 19, right? Now see the next one. We have to tell the element for which the row number is 2 and column number is 1. So let us come to the row number 2, right? And column number 1. So this is the required element, 35. A33, row number is 3 and column number is also 3. So A33, row number 3 means this row and column number is 3 means this. So the required element is minus 5. Now row number is 2, column number is 4, A24. So row number 2 is this and column number 4 is this. So intersection is at this point, right? So it will be 12. Now see the next one. A23, row number is 2 and column number is 3, right? So row number 2, this is the row and column number is 3, means this element, 5 upon 2. In this way, your question number 1 is solved. Now, if a matrix has 24 elements, what are the possible orders it can have? If total number of elements are given, then how can we find the possible order of that matrix? It is very simple to find the possible orders. Just hame kya karna hai beta, hame ye pata karna hai ki ye jo total number of elements hai, inko hum kitne ways se, kitne tarikon se do factors mein factorize kar sakte hain, right? 24 को जैसे हम बेटा 1 into 24 लिख सकते हैं, 2 into 12 लिख सकते हैं, 3 into 8 लिख सकते हैं, okay? So the possible orders are 1 into 24 means we can take a matrix in which there are 24 rows and 1 column. We can take a matrix in which 12 rows and 2 columns. We can take a matrix in which 8 rows and 3 columns, right? In all these cases, there will be 24 elements in the matrix. We can also take a matrix in which there are 6 rows and 4 columns. 4 rows, 6 columns. Now take the reverse. Interchange the number of rows and columns. These are the possible orders of the matrix having 24 elements. Now, if in a matrix, the number of total number of entries is a prime number, then there are only two possible order, because a prime number can be factorized into two ways only, into two factors by two ways only. See, if a matrix have 13 elements, then possible orders are 1 cross 13 or 13 cross 1. It means that we can take 1 row and 13 columns or 13 rows, 1 column. There are only two possible order. Okay. Now, see the question number 3. Question number 3 is same as question number 2. So, you can do it yourself. Now, see the next problem. In problem number 4, we have to construct a 2 by 2 matrix whose elements are given by this formula. Aij is equal to I plus j ka whole square upon 2. Right? Where I denotes the row number and j denotes the column number. So 2 by 2 matrix looks like this, right? A11, A12, A21 and A22. There are 2 rows and 2 columns. Means we have to find these entries A11, A12, A21, A22. First number is the value of I and second number is the value of j. Right, first number denote the row number and second number denote the column number. Right, so first of all we will calculate these four elements. First of all we calculate A11. Let us calculate A11 means the value of I is also 1 and value of j is also 1. So simply put, I and j equal to 1, 1 plus 1 ka whole square upon 2, its value will be 2. Means the value of A11 must be 2. This value is 2. Right? Now, see the next one. The value of A12. Put the value of I equal to 1 and j equal to 2. So, 1 plus 2 ka whole square upon 2. It is equal to 9 upon 2. So, value of A12 is equal to 9 upon 2. Right? Now, A21. What is the value of A21? Put the value of I is equal to 2 and j equal to 1. Its value is again 9 upon 2. So, simply write its value 9 upon 2. 9 upon 2. Now, see the next one. The value of A22. For A22, the value of I is 2 and j is 2. So simply put, I is equal to 2 and j is equal to 2. So 2 plus 2 ka whole square upon 2. Its value is 8. So A22 is 8. The value of A22 is 8. We have found all the values. So simply remove this A11, A21. A12 and A22. This is your required matrix. 2, 9 upon 2, 9 upon 2 and 8. This is the required matrix. Now let us see the next problem. Aij, I upon j. Simply you can calculate. Now the third part. In a similar manner as the first part, you can calculate the third part also. You can solve the third part also. I have solved. The solution is given in the solution. Aij is equal to I upon j. For A11, the value of I and j will be 1. So 1 upon 1. The value of I is 1 and the value of j is 2. 1 upon 2. A21, the value of I is 2 and the value of j is 1. So 2 upon 1. The value of I is 2, the value of j is 2. 2 upon 2. Right? Similarly, you can do the third part of this question. Now, फिफ्थ प्रॉब्लम इज व्हाट. इन फिफ्थ वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ 3x4 मैट्रिक्स हुज एलिमेंट्स आर गिवन बाय, मींस वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ मैट्रिक्स विच हैव 3 रोज एंड 4 कॉलम्स, मींस वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट a11 a12 a13 a14. 3x4 मैट्रिक्स लुक्स लाइक दैट. इट हैज 3 रोज, 3 हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइंस एंड 4 कॉलम्स, राइट. In each entry, simply put the value of I and J according to this formula and calculate. A11, the value of I is 1 and J is 1. So, 1/2 minus 3 into 1 plus 1. Okay. Now, after simple calculation, you will get this required answer. Now, see the next problem. In problem number 6, we have to find the values of X, Y, Z from the following equation. Means, we have to use the concept of equality of the matrices, right? For equality of the matrices, matrix must be of the same order and corresponding entries must be equal. Means 4 is equal to y. See, these two matrix are equal, means corresponding entries are equal. Here a11 is 4, here a11 is y. So 4 is equal to y, means the value of y must be 4. Now, here a12 is equal to 3, here a12 is equal to z, means 3 is equal to z, the value of z is 3. Here x and the corresponding entry will be 1, so x must be equal to 1. Here 5, here is also 5, so no problem, right. In this way, you will get the value z is equal to 3, y is equal to 4 and x equal to 1. Now see the next one, x plus y plus z equal to 9. X plus Z is equal to 5, Y plus Z equal to 7. So we have 3 equation and 3 unknown. Simply, first of all, subtract the second equation from first equation. When we will subtract the second equation from first equation, X and Z will be cancelled, right? In left hand side, Y is left only. And in right hand side, 9 minus 5, it is equal to 4. You will get the answer y is equal to 4. Simply subtract equation 3 from equation 1, you will get x is equal to 2, right. Now put the value of x in equation 2, you will get the value of z, right. Now let us see the next problem. In problem number 8, we are asked that a matrix is a square matrix. We very well know that the fact a matrix is a square matrix if number of rows is equal to the number of columns, then it looks like a square arrangement, right. So here the number of rows will be what, m, and number of column will be n. So for a square matrix, number of row must be equal to number of column, so m must be equal to n. So right option is c, right. Now see the next one. Which of the given values of x and y make the following pair of matrices equal? 3x plus 7, simply compare the two matrices, because both are the equal. So 3x plus 7 equal to 0, 5 is equal to y minus 2, y plus 1 is equal to 8, and 2 minus 3x is equal to 4. Now after solving these equations, we will get two values of x, right. Hamay x ki beta do value mili. अब बेटा अगर आपको x की दो वैल्यूज़ मिल गई, मतलब x की कोई एक ऐसी कॉमन वैल्यू आपको नहीं मिली जो इक्वेशंस को साइमल्टेनियसली एक साथ सेटिस्फाई करे, राइट. सिंस वी हैव टू वैल्यूज ऑफ x, सो इट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ x एंड y. मेक द फॉलोइंग पेयर ऑफ मैट्रिसेस आर इक्वल. क्योंकि y की तो बेटा कॉमन वैल्यू आपको मिल गई 7, लेकिन x की आपको दो डिफरेंट वैल्यूज मिली. अगर आप x माइनस 7 अपॉन 3 लोगे तो ये इक्वेशन सेटिस्फाई नहीं होगी, और अगर x माइनस 2 अपॉन 3 लोगे तो ये वाली इक्वेशन सेटिस्फाई नहीं होगी, राइट. सो दिस इज द रीजन वी आर अनेबल टू फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ x एंड y सो दैट द गिवन पेयर ऑफ द मैट्रिसेस आर इक्वल. ओके, सो राइट ऑप्शन इज बी, not possible to find. Now see the next problem. The number of all possible matrices of order 3 cross 3 in which the entry 0 or 1. So let us see the picture. In question number 10, we have to tell the number of all possible matrices of order थ्री क्रॉस थ्री विद ईच एंट्री जीरो और वन। मीन्स हमको बेटा वो सारे मैट्रिसेस बताने हैं, टोटल नंबर ऑफ ऐसे कितने मैट्रिस होंगे जिनके जो उनका ऑर्डर थ्री बाई थ्री हो और जिनकी एंट्री या तो जीरो हो और वन हो। मीन्स हमारे पास कुछ कंडीशन इस तरीके से है, आपके पास एक थ्री बाई थ्री की मैट्रिक्स है और आप उसकी हर एंट्री पे या तो वन भर सकते हो या जीरो फिल कर सकते हो। सबसे पहले बेटा मतलब आपके पास सारी एंट्रीज के लिए दो दो च्वाइसेस हैं, पहली एंट्री के लिए भी देखो दो च्वाइस हैं, दूसरी एंट्री के लिए भी दो च्वाइस हैं, तीसरी एंट्री के लिए भी दो च्वाइस हैं, सारी एंट्रीज के लिए आपके पास दो च्वाइसेस हैं। और आपके पास बेटा टोटल नंबर ऑफ एंट्रीज कितनी है, लेट अस काउंट, वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट एंड नाइन। मीन्स वी हैव टोटल नाइन एंट्रीज एंड फॉर ईच एंट्री वी हैव टू च्वाइस। मीन्स द टोटल नंबर ऑफ मैट्रिसेस विल बी टू इंटू 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 टू, राइट? हाउ मेनी टाइम्स? नाइन टाइम्स, सी, राइट? सो इट इज इक्वल टू टू रेज टू द पावर नाइन, राइट? एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ टू रेज टू द पावर नाइन इज व्हाट? फाइव वन टू। ओके, इज इट क्लियर? We have nine entries and for each entry we have two choices. So total number of matrices will be 2 raised to the power 9 and which is equal to 512. So in this way your first exercise 3.1 is completed. Now if you have any query, any doubt in this exercise, you can tell me in comment section. Thanks for watching this video. Have a good day. Goodbye.